Welcome to TheoTrade. This is Don Kaufman. July 6th, 2020. Minutes to go to the cash close on this Monday following a holiday weekend. What's the market giving us today? Well, the S&Ps may be up about 40 handles coming into the close. That's good for 1.25%. But it is just a chopped out slumpfest on an intraday basis. If you kind of understand what that means, for those of you that do trade on an intraday level, I'm calling it a chopped out slop fest, well, simply in respect to the fact that the marketplace had opened here. It threatened to go lower. It went higher. It threatened to go lower. It almost went higher. You get it. It's a slop fest out there. Now, there are a couple things that are real standouts in this trading session before we dig into, okay, expected move. And I'm going to reiterate this time and again, the expected move, okay, indicates a correction is imminent. And we're going to look at that index product here in just a minute. But before we actually dig into expected move and start getting very quantitative kind of in how we assess, you know, why we believe that a correction is imminent, before we get anywhere, okay, near that, let's actually touch, again, on the overall S&Ps, which have moved 40. The SPX is actually up some approximately 50 bucks. Now, I want to zoom into this for just a moment because I think it's statistically significant such that you're only expecting an $80 move throughout the entire course of the week. $80 move higher, $80 move lower, and we're more than halfway home to the edge of the expected move. And again, we're what, you know, one day into the trading week here. Whole lot of week left for some movement. Nevertheless, okay, that isn't even that much of a standout. I've seen crazier stuff happen. The standout's the fact that when you start looking at the volatility futures, you start looking at the VIX, Their bid with the markets up huge. An indication, if you will, of the professional world is literally buying volatility. You know, even if the VIX finished slightly down in the day, doesn't that look unusual to you to see the S&Ps up by 1.3%, the Nasdaq flying by, you know, 2.3%? And yet, again, we have volatility ever so slightly bid. So I took a bit more of a detailed look into this, and specifically I went into the volatility futures. You look at the volatility futures on an intraday level, they were bidding up all throughout the course of the day. Yeah, they're backing off here a little bit. But again, it's unusual to see volatility bid 4 minutes left in a trading day and the S&P's up. So I looked at 16-day volatility, and that's up some 20 cents, but I went a little bit further out into the curve. And this is the kind of stuff where, it's worth taking the time to dig. A little further out in the curve, though, volatility futures, they're not backing off at all. So then I cruised down towards the bottom of the screen, and I looked at what I kind of call my volatility complex. And is it complex? No. But you've got 9-day volatility, 3-month volatility, and the VVIX. I mean, the VVIX is in Never Neverland. I mean, it's in the VAMA zone. Anything north of 110 is the VAMA zone. That's the volatility of the volatility index, and it is volatile. 116 in change, and they're buying it again on a day that the marketplace is up substantially. That, to me, is a little bit of a shot across the bow, and I think you should pay attention to it. Now, on top of it, the bonds, they refused to really back down today. Nevertheless, the financials did bid higher, but still a very muted range. And I say a very muted range as compared to expected move. Nevertheless, the financials did pretty much tag the upper edge of the expected move and pulled back in from it. Now, with all of that being said, okay, and we're going to push all that aside for a second, here's what we really need to look at, and here's where I said we believe that a correction is very likely imminent, specifically in regards to the Nasdaq, the QQQ. It's rare that I come on to any evening video and I talk about, you know, a correction, you know, possibly being imminent, but let's actually look at the statistics behind this. What you're going to look at here is auto expected moves. Now, in auto expected moves, what that does is it applies, okay, a weekly expected move, okay, directly over to your chart. Now I'm going to close up this left side bar, and I'm going to zoom in for just a moment here, right into it. Okay, why and what about this expected move, okay, reeks that a correction could be imminent. Now, anything that I do here, I would assign probabilities. That's not a definitive, like, all right, you know, this thing is absolutely going to correct. Okay. We looked back quite extensively at breaches, okay, of the QQQ through the expected move. It is highly, okay, highly unlikely that the QQQ has two or even three breaches to the upside of expected move. In fact, what I'm going to show you here right now is simply this. Last week, we were on a four-day trading week, okay, and the Nasdaq absolutely shattered the upside of the expected move. Okay, today, there's no difference. I mean, literally, we're 5 minutes into the trading session this morning, and the Nasdaq was already breaching the upside of the expected move. Now, one of the things that I looked back at initially is, okay, and we've had a fairly wicked rally, obviously, in the Nasdaq since it touched down, and this is the cues, touched down all the way, okay, to about the 165 level here, again, in the QQQ. But even as you zoom into this, one of the most wild rallies ever inside of this product, you will can only really find here is 1-2 weeks in a row where it actually shattered the upside of the expected move. As it shattered the upside of the expected move in the second week, a violent, okay, and really huge pullback actually occurred. That's actually the cues going from the 215 level, pulling all the way back, okay, in this neighborhood of about 205. It was slightly less than that. It's about a $10 actual drawdown that occurred in a very, very short period of time. Now, you can actually look back through a just massive amount of expected moves, and I'm kind of taking you forward to the present here. This is a huge move outside expected. Again, this morning we actually crack right to the upside of the expected move. There's the closing bell. But as you scroll back through time, and I, you know, challenge everybody, scroll back through an ample amount of time. Here's also another breach to the upside. Okay, and I'm going to zoom in on this for you for a second. Here's another breach of expected move to the upside. There it is. Okay, there's actually the second week to the outside, and immediately a violent correction. So I looked back, and effectively, what I found here in, again, just a very small amount of data, and this is without going too much more in detail, with a very small amount of data, you can, by the way, you can open up 3 years, you can even open up 5 years, just look through a small amount of data. Okay, the number of times we actually cracked through the edge of the expected move in two consecutive weeks was extremely limited. Okay, so I couldn't even find that much data. However, the percentage move up right now is substantially beyond any of the other, okay, breaches of expected move. And again, we're talking about two subsequent breaches of expected move. So here's where I want to leave you with looking at this. And again, this is a much more quantitative take, and without completely geeking out on you, all right, the percentage move up is extraordinary. It's violent. It's not to say this move can have continuation throughout the course of this week. We would expect that then sell side activity to be absolutely imminent in the third week. That would be extending, of course, into the following week, if it can even make it through this week. I'm going to tell you, there is absolutely no timing this. I don't want to hear that, you know, you didn't time it right and the MACD turned. And listen, there's not going to be any timing for this. We'll breach. If we continue to go up this week, we could snap back and snap back hard. There is the possibility, okay, that we could hold out higher, all right, literally to the end of this week, and then pull back hard next week. Nevertheless, we are in, again, very wild territory for the percentage move up, and it was initially the expected move that brought this to our attention, okay? So again, inside of the NASDAQ, we expect that a correction will occur, really, without, you know, without further ado, either this trading week or, of course, next trading week, we're going to get a fairly substantial pullback. Many ways to trade that. Obviously, I'm going to go through numerous ways to trade it tomorrow morning right after the cash open. Also, want to give everybody a quick heads up. I traded in the TLT today. This is where I actually had purchased an iron condor. I'll display that in a bit more detail, of course, in the first thing in the morning. And last but not least, inside of the GLD trades are working. We're actually about to crack the range over here. We have a profitable iron condor on. And I want to reiterate, this is buy side iron condors, both in GLD and TLT. Stay tuned for first thing tomorrow morning. We're going to detail both the GLD trades, the TLT trades, and of course, what we can do in the NASDAQ when we believe that a correction is imminent. Thanks, everybody, for joining us here at TheoTrade. Have a wonderful evening. Bye-bye.